Unit 6. The Children of Ancient Rome.
In ancient Rome, when a baby was born, families observed a simple birth ceremony to mark the occasion. According to custom, the infant was placed before the father, who then picked it up to symbolically accept the baby into the family. Once they got a bit older, Roman children spent their leisure time socializing, playing games, and having fun. Pets were common, including typical animals like dogs, as well as some that might seem unusual today, like pigeons, geese, and monkeys. Just like modern kids, Roman kids loved playing with toys. Parents provided their children with stilts, kites, marbles, and the ankle bones of a sheep, which were used to play a traditional game called knuckle bones. Roman youth played other games too, such as tic-tac-toe and board games, in addition to war games, which were especially popular among boys. The clothing worn by Roman kids was not very similar to the fashions we wear now. They typically wore a kind of dress known as a toga, which was made out of a long, draping piece of material wrapped across the body. In addition, boys and girls wore a piece of jewelry called a pulla, a necklace that was supposed to protect them during childhood. It included a locket that held special charms to ward off evil. In Rome's earliest days, a child's education was the responsibility of his or her parents. Boys learned to read and write, and girls learned to sew and weave. Eventually, formal schools were created, and some children began to receive education outside the home. However, schooling was not free, and many families could not afford to send their children to be formally educated. At school, children of wealthy parents were instructed in basic subjects, like reading, writing, and math. Many girls, though, did not receive any schooling at all. At 12 or 13, boys from wealthy families studied Latin and Greek grammar and literature. At 16, they had the opportunity to study public speaking, which was a very important skill for Romans. When kids grew up, their opportunities were highly influenced by their gender. Men typically worked outside the home, while women were usually confined to managing the house and household finances. They were not allowed to hold government positions or to be lawyers or teachers. Those careers were only for wealthy men who had received a special education when they were younger.